Hi everybody, welcome to your weekly oracle here for the new week. And yeah, happy birthday if you are a Pisces and you already had your birthday or even today. So happy, happy birthday and all the best for you. If you are new to my channel, I am a tarot reader and also a numerologist and a singer and a singing and piano coach. And I'm combining all my spirituality and all this gift with the music and always with a song, which is always something else in every month. So now we have Pisces. You know, in the last month there was a theme for Aquarius, and before that we had, for example, Capricorn. And for Capricorn I just did some country music. For the Aquarian people, there was some jazz music and so on and so on. And now this is a surprise for you guys for the new month, for March. It will be the release of the new song here, so you can just watch again my videos. I would really appreciate that if you want to know how it sounds. And yeah, and of course we're gonna just take a look in the energies here for the new week for you guys. This oracle is just in a way that you can just make a choice here, because I have three symbols. I have here a symbol number one, and the task for you is a little bit just trust your intuition and just go with your intuition. And if you feel like drawn to this symbol, then make this choice for that. Then I have here an eye. So these eyes, you get them always in Turkey when you're, for example, there for vacations, and they save you from the bad luck, let's say it like that, from black magic even. So this is like the people believe there, and I think it also fits very nice to Pisces, because it's like this vacation and hanging around on the beach and so and so. And yeah. And we have here also the symbol number three. And now I just give you, so you just have to choose that symbol that is drawn to you. And I just give you a few seconds and you can make your choice. And if it's too fast for you, you can always stop this video and keep on watching it when you made your choice, all right? Okay, good. I just start, okay? I just start here with that symbol for you guys, if you made this choice for that. I'm working here with two tarot decks. And I also have special decks here also for you, and they're a little bit different, but all in general, it's a very, very nice message here coming out. So we don't need to always have these tarot cards. We can also, you know, make oracles of anything, you know. You can even, yeah, I don't know, you can throw some stones. There's also I Ching and all that stuff, or runes and so. And I'm just using just several decks here, okay? Just put your feet on the ground and really take a good seat on planet Earth, right? On Mother Earth. And make sure that that nothing is like, that everything is flowing free of your energies inside of your body. All right, so these cards are wanting to be chosen, health and soul. We got the four, and he is looking very, very weird here. Four is actually safety, but four can also be that you have to fight a little bit for your health here. Let's take a look what also the tarot is going to tell us. Oh yeah, this card is already wanted to be picked up. Sometimes they're very fast and sometimes not. I have the feeling that you are very content here. Maybe that could be a little bit a problem, maybe with too much alcohol for some of you. alcohol or any kind of, let's say, drugs, okay? This is just something, I just say it because it's a little bit, it's a general reading. It can apply to you very much on a personal level and also not. So this is like really for all of you guys. And I just see, I don't know, that somebody is really like, don't want to really take care of business, let's say, like that. Take care of the health a little bit and just don't want to deal with any kind of issues here. But you have really, really a very, very good future, and I think that for the most of you, the health is quite stable thing here. Okay. So, and if you have maybe, no, I just have the feeling that you're celebrating, that you also feel you're very good, and also in your emotional well-being that you feel you're quite good in this week. This is, I think, a very good message now. Okay, so let's just take a look into your love life now. Your love life. They wanna be chosen. We have here the Six of Pentacles. Maybe there will be some presents. Maybe somebody is inviting you for a dinner or to go out somewhere, okay? Or you invite somebody. This is, or you just spend money to somebody, or you just give money to somebody, or you receive something. But I just see here that there is not really a commitment. Maybe the feelings are not like safe enough, or just let's say it like that. Maybe you don't know if you're really in love or the other person, okay? There can be a little bit a tendency that you guys don't really know which direction to go here, or this person is not really so so important to you, for you, yeah? You could be single and have somebody in your mind, or just meeting somebody, and this somebody that is like really indecisive situation, let's say that like that. If it's like we need to make a decision in a relationship or as a single with somebody you know already, it's still the indecisiveness. I don't see here any kind of a tendency to get in a relationship. And I have also the feeling that maybe you try to not overspend your money. Not overspend your money. And I don't know, I just have the feeling that maybe the topic and the theme of the week is maybe more money. More the money than really the love and the emotions, yeah? Maybe you're not so much in love, or you just have just the money on your mind, or you just are just working a lot. I don't see here just romantic emotions. I don't see it that. I could imagine that the most of you are just... singles, maybe, okay? Singles are not so much romantically involved, and I see still the indecisiveness in that. And you could be also married or just coupled, and still there is just no decision to make. And maybe everybody in this marriage or so is just working on their things here, and there is not really a romantic commitment, okay? This is what I'm getting here. Can you change it, and what could you do? You could, you know, what you could do is really to be initiative and active, and maybe, you know, really when you're a woman, to be really that hot female, maybe not to overdo it in that way, but, you know, just to dress up, let your hair down and just go out and maybe flirt or just meet somebody. That could be something. Or when you're a couple, that could be that you should maybe, you know, improve a little bit, or just, you know, wake up your erotic sides, or your just your sensual sides here, and your activeness. And maybe you should just tell your partner, hey, let's just do again something together, something nice, maybe also with the children if you have children, and just go outside and just do something active. And this activity, okay? So the key word is here activity, and also femininity. That's what I get here. And for the man, that could be just having the passion and the power to go really for that active woman, or that woman who is very self-esteemed, maybe you're afraid to really go there and tell her that you really like her or something, but just, you know, just have the courage. I just get that maybe if it's for men, you should just have the courage and everything is gonna be all right, and just, you know, try to make the approach. This is what I'm getting a little bit for you guys. Okay, good. And what about your finances? Finances and job. If you're working, that's really too much work. And it's really like very interesting, because I have the feeling that you are afraid not to have enough money. Maybe you just have to check that out, if it's really, really that real, okay? And it's really also in your love life. Maybe this is like just too much concentration on career and on money, that your love life is like a little bit not really alive here. But anyways, this is just for 1 week. Right? Okay, but this is what I get. Maybe it's also a little bit a lack of money here too, so it could be that your sorrows, if you have some, could be real also in this week, and you don't earn so much as you want to. All right, okay, this is what I'm getting here. Yeah, and what you should do is just accept the situation. It's only 1 week and it will just pass by. Okay, and I have also some extra cards here for your project that you maybe do when you, for example, working in a regular job and you want to be self-employed and you're building up a business. Or if it's maybe something artistic, something creative that you also do, what will be with that, okay? Or anything like that. And if you don't have any extra stuff to do, maybe these are just, the further career steps, okay? You have to make your choice. That could be that you're very creative here, that you really start something new. Could be also the tendency, or maybe the thought, to get pregnant and have a child. That could be also the case. That's also creative. That's the most creative thing we can do as human beings on this earth, to have children and to make a family, for example. Or this is just something new that you want to start here, okay? But I have the feeling the start is not yet there, but it's really like forming in your mind, and you gives you really a creative feeling to it. And we have here also the King of Cups. That's also a very active and a male energy. So I have the feeling that could be creative projects here, or you are talking about your project or your idea here with this man. Okay, that could be also good, because this man, he can be a water sign, but it's not necessary. It must not be a water sign. Could be also some characteristica of a water sign, Scorpio, Pisces, or Cancer. And these people, very often, I'm a Pisces, I'm an artist, and I'm a spiritual person, so it's very typical. I'm a typical Pisces, okay? And I have in my chart so much Pisces, that's crazy. And and all these forecasts on YouTube, I always watch Pisces. I don't watch any moon signs or something. I would recommend also to watch your moon and your rising sign for sure, if you are not that fixed in something or so. I'm so much Pisces that for me it just fits Pisces, and that's it, you know. But you know, these are just typical things. Maybe this man here, he could be a friend, he could be a boss, he could be a coach, yeah? He could be also a coach for any kind of, maybe he's also your voice teacher, who knows, you know what I mean? And he will maybe know a lot about the thing that you want to do, and you can really, you know, have a very, very a fruitful conversation, which also really blows your mind, okay? Which also makes you very, very happy. And sun, oh my god. So whatever you have in your mind, I see it very positive, very, very positive. If it's a pregnancy, or if he's the father of the child, or if he's a friend or somebody who just really you can talk to, just do it. It's very positive, okay? Good. So I am working here also with Dark Fairy Tarot here from the Scarabeus from Lo Scarabeo, alright? I have to mention that. And also here with the Rider-Waite traditional tarot, alright? Good, so thank you a lot here, my dear group. And we keep on doing here. With the eye, alright? Okay, your wellness, well-being, how are you? Physically, emotional, yeah. They already want to be picked, yeah? Oh, the devil. Maybe it's a drug addiction, maybe it's an addiction to any kind of medicine, okay? The industry of pharma stuff, it's maybe not that trustful sometimes, you know? Yeah, that could be also an addiction to a person, right? It could be also a little sexual addiction. It could be also or addiction to love. We can be addicted to anything. Or you are bound to a person here, okay? And there is a lot of arguing which is just drowning you, okay? Which is just drowning you. Or you believe too much doctors or something. But I don't see it. I just see it more like... you have to free yourself here and maybe initiate really some way out here. Maybe this is the great week to really, really, really try to stand on your own feet here and not be caught into that. But I see this tendency quite strong here. For some of you, it's an addiction. For the other one, it could be just a restriction that you feel bound to somebody here or something, and it would be better to think about how to get rid of that. But it's still in this week lying there, okay? So what about your love life? Alright, so this one here. Yeah, that could be also sexuality here. Or just a new chance here in a marriage or in a relationship that could be just, yeah, some new fire. Okay? Positive, actually. Devil, and a very, very fiery man. Maybe you're coupled here with an Aries or with an Leo or with any kind of, with the other fire sign in Sagittarius. But it's not sad. I mean, it's just a tendency. That could be just very passionate men or women also, because we have yet a general reading. And a lot of fighting and arguing, okay? But also a lot of fire and passion. And also you have the chance to maybe... a really start something new to really get rid out of this toxic thing. Whoever on whatever it is, I think you will know. It's general reading, all right? If you wanna, you know, have a deeper look in the card, you can always contact me, of course, right? Via email, WhatsApp and so. Stand your ground and really initiate on yourself and make own decisions. That will save you here. Because you have really chances to really, really find good partners or just find more like hot partners. That's for sure, okay? This is what I'm getting here for you. If you are single or coupled, you can also be in a marriage relationship, which is just a little bit like, yeah, it's passionate in anything. But it could be just too much passion or just in a way that you actually don't enjoy it anymore. It could be also a thing like that, okay? Everything which is to do with power struggles and so on, addictions, could be just the devil. But you can really, you have to stand your ground, okay? You have to really make a fence around yourself and really, really, really trust in your own strength. Because you have a lot of, you can initiate on your own. I see that. You have the strength for sure. And if you need some help, just... contact me, right? Alright, so let's see your finances. Finances and career, just your job, okay? Job, career, and anything like this. Three of Cups, partying. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Nine of Pentacles. Oh wow, I see here a lot of money. And save money also. Yeah, there is some money, there is some passion, there is some fire, but there is the devil, and the devil is always saying, like, when you have something, you really have to pay the price in a way. And this is just the devil, okay? Whatever you are doing here, which is maybe where the price is too high, just be aware of that, yeah? This is what I'm getting. This is what I'm seeing here for you guys. Okay, so let's just take a look in your business, which you do aside. That could be something that you want to earn money, but it's not yet there, for example, right? Or just a little, or your creative project, or just your next steps into your career. Yeah, we have here, oh, a beautiful and a very stable lady. And I see just a lot of success here. Yeah, and a lot of money and so. Mm-hmm. Wow, you're really on the top, right? In a way, that's nice. Okay. Yeah. Everybody loves you. Beautiful. Okay. So thank you, group. This one here. And we keep on doing with you guys, all right? Okay, let's just check out your health and your well-being here in the week. Yeah, they want already a lot of stability. Everything is just fine and it's okay. No problems, actually. Yeah, I see stability here. Yes. Yes, and you are also financially here very stable, and you feel it and you enjoy it here also, and this is very good. Still, there are maybe some anxieties, maybe some depression or sadnesses, okay? You have to heal here. What about if you just really actively do something about it, maybe with a psychotherapist or with anybody who can help you, whatever it might be for you, these anxieties, yeah? Maybe you are afraid of anything. Maybe you're afraid that you're not stable, but I see you are, okay? But you can really fight that feeling and you can be successful, but you really have to have the willpower to do so. But at least I just feel you see really stability, and this is very nice. Good. All right, and also financially very much. What about your love life? The Hanged Man. You're in a crisis. For whatever you're waiting or something, you will keep on waiting here in this week. It will be better in a way, but not in this week here. Yeah. There is this tendency to really get free, to really become free. I just see also the Two of Swords, yeah, and you don't know which way to go. Maybe you're in a marriage or something, or you're coupled, and you don't know which way to go now. And I just see that you are just hanging limbo here in this week, but maybe you just need this time to really get clear for what you really want and what you should do, because there is really a tendency to really get rid out of situations which are not that good for you, maybe, okay? But still, you have to maybe just ask yourself, or maybe just, maybe these are also issues within yourself. Maybe you have to first love yourself and really get rid out of negative feelings, thoughts, and stuff like this. That could be also the case. I see here the chance to really free yourself from anything which is toxic or so, but maybe in this week you're still a little bit, but I actually like the Hanged Man, because the Hanged Man has just a chance to really chill and just to, you know, to relax and to accept the situation. Can be very healing, and that can be also very beneficial and can also feel very good. Enjoy this week, yeah? Because there will be a decision made, and you will just find your way. You need this time to maybe just go within you, to meditate over it, to be in this state of just being upside down here and just enjoy, that you just hang and you just don't need anything to do, then just meditate over it, accept what's going on, that it's not a fast energy, and the solution will come into your mind and you will know which way to go. That's what I'm getting here very much. And if you're single, of course, this is actually the same meaning. That could be just that could be that you don't want to be single anymore. Still, you have to wait. Yeah, it will be better. It will be better, 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 and you will have more chances soon. Yeah, but not in this week. This is what I'm getting. And if there are any kind of mental stuff or so, you will get rid of that when, I cannot tell you, but there is a chance to really free yourself from anything which is just maybe not good for you or toxic or anything like that. Okay. Yeah, but not yet. And what about your finances? We have here is fallen out, the Six of Cups. It could be some contact from your past. That could be any kind of past job or something you actually think about to do again. It could be also children. Children, okay? And we have here the Hierophant, and the Hierophant is just telling me, just trust. Trust, everything is gonna be alright. I don't see here the big money cards, but I just see that you are stable enough here. That you're stable enough and you can trust. And we have here the Seven of Swords here. You have to stand your ground. Maybe you have to, not let everybody into your life or too close to you. That would be really important to really do so. And that will bring you out of a situation that you just feel like everything is too much. You maybe feel like everything is kind of too much. And you have to really stand your ground and really have your boundaries here. And if you do that, then you can just trust the situation and everything is gonna be all right also with the money. And this week you will just have enough money. I think you will not sorrow about that. But I just see here that this boundaries need to be made, okay? In general. All right, so what about your heart business or your career steps? Or just every business or anything that you are building aside, but it's not yet there? Yeah, that could be just this, like, for everybody something else, for artists also. Yeah, if you are an artist and you want to earn some with that, or just want to have a business or anything. And if you are just, you know, happy with everything which is like that, so maybe these could be also further career steps here into your life, in your business, or just further steps to just improve in your life here. This is your, you must define it for you, okay? And then the answers will be given now. We have here the King of Swords. The King of Cups. Yeah. That could be just work with men. Work with men, or just get some help from men. From attorneys, maybe from somebody who, from any kind of advisors that can give you a good advice. Just grab this chance, because they can maybe give you a good hint for a new direction into your career here. Okay, so thank you a lot, group. What did we have? The Eye, right? Good. Or was it this? I don't remember, but you know. Okay, you know which symbol I had, I would say. And now we are just doing the last group. So I pick here these children cards. They're also quite interesting. Oh, they want already. In your health. Oh my gosh, oh, that's sweet. And we have here the Eight. And we have abundance. Oh God, I have the feeling that you are very abundant here and you know what you have and you really, really enjoy what you have here in your life. It could be money, that could be just anything where you just are abundant and happy about that, all right? Yeah. I'm sorry. And here we have, yeah, the Six of Wands. And I have a feeling we have enough information. You are here very happy. Maybe you won a lottery, or maybe you just know what you have in your life and that's exactly that what you want. And you maybe win here something or somebody over or something. Or you just win over a kind of crisis or anything like that. Or maybe you just also move. That could be also an indication that some of you could move. But your health and your vitality and just your well-being is just very super nice here. It's very nice. Very good. Looking good. Okay, and what about your love life? Oh yeah, they wanna. We have, the Five of Swords. Some arguing, maybe some. Yeah. Could be that you are maybe in a divorce, some of you, or you are fighting with your partner about something, maybe about money here. Maybe the partner is not really moving into your direction. Maybe you are talk, or discuss, and they don't move really into your direction, and it's annoying, okay? And I have just the feeling that you have to find the right words to get in touch with him or with her. They just need maybe some few more words. It's up to you how you communicate here. But there could be also a thing that the partner is just going his or her way already, but very slowly. They may be a little bit indecisive here. That could be also some bad behavior here in this relationship, I could say. For singles, it could be just that that you maybe are just that you don't feel so good about love here, and your heart is still broken maybe from a past situation. That's what I'm feeling totally. And you're angry. Release your anger here. When you release your anger and you really, you know, you really just feel what happens and you really accept it and you work on it for yourself, then the situation will just shift. And you have really good chances here. Just heal it in a way that you can really move forward, okay? It just needs time. It needs time to heal the wounds here in this week. This is what I'm getting. If you're single or married, okay, it's just a broken heart. I'm sorry. What about now your finances? And I see here the Moon. Yeah. But children, and that's interesting. I don't know. I have the feeling that you are happy because of your children here. This is very interesting. And now that could be also the Prince of Water, could be also a child here, or just messages, lovely messages, or just somebody is telling you like, oh yeah, we actually want you to be our employee or something. And we have here, but I have the feeling that the concentration is more on family, more on children, and maybe you're pregnant. That could be also the case. You have to be very diplomatic with your partner if you're here in a relationship. Yeah, maybe there are some. It's maybe up to you. You have to be really, really diplomatic here with him or her. I think maybe with him when you're pregnant. Also, when you are a man, yeah, it could be that your wife is pregnant here, or just that the concentration is more on children and on family and less on work. It could be just for a general if that comes a new child or not. Okay. Okay, and what about your heart business? Yeah. I see you, the Magician. You're very creative, you're very gifted, and you really can make it. Good. You can really make it, you have to believe it. We have here the Wish card, and yeah. I don't see your money yet, but I see a really, really a nice potential, and just follow it and just let it blossom. All right? Good, guys, so this was your weekly oracle. Thank you a lot for watching, for liking and sharing and subscribing. And yeah, when you subscribe, you will always know which new song it will be in the particular month. If you would like to have a personal reading, then please contact me via email or even via WhatsApp. And you will just get an info mail on the service that you chose. Yeah, I'm working for ages, forever with the cards, with the tarot cards here, with the numerology also. And I also give here in Zurich, but also online singing lessons and piano lessons. All right. So just contact me and so. And I always like to read your comments and so. And thank you a lot and have a wonderful week. See you. Bye bye.